And the weapons that they're talking about banning look like assault rifles. They are a civilian version of the assault rifles, and we need to understand why that is. That is because the majority of Americans have a familiarity with these type of weapons from their service in the military, from their history in the U.S. military. These are civilian versions of the military fully automatic weapons. So none of the weapons that we're talking about, the ones that were used in Orlando or in Columbine or in any of these sites of these devastating massacres and murders of innocent people, were actually fully automatic weapons. But we always hear the term that these are automatic weapons. They're not automatic weapons. The United States exports automatic version of these weapons. In fact, the number one producer of arms in the world is the United States government. It's the United States corporations, and it's the United States gun industry, the manufacturer of these weapons, that make billions of dollars a year selling them into Africa, giving them to their allies in Syria and their allies in North Africa that are behind the NRA. The NRA is not funded by some trailer, by some white boy in a trailer with a gun in his pickup. It's funded by the multinational arms dealers, by the arms industry. By Remington, Colt. These are the major funders behind the RNA, behind the NRA. And this is one of the reasons why the NRA is so powerful. It's not powerful because it enjoys the support of ordinary white citizens. Ordinary white citizens are just as susceptible to being accused of terrorism as black folks are in the post-9/11 era. All Americans are potential criminals and terrorists in the eyes of Homeland Security and the government. And so it is the arms industry, the multi-billion dollar a year arms industry that is behind the NRA, that is behind the lobbying efforts that went into Congress and the display that we recently saw on the Senate floor, where none of these no bills to even ameliorate the phony gun laws that they do have even passed. So let's not get this twisted. It's the weapons industry. The military-industrial complex of which the NRA is a civilian adjunct. It's a civilian expression. It's what you call a lobbying instrument for the arms industry to lobby Congress and to put their position forward. And so, if we are seriously talking about a ban on weapons in the United States, we have to understand first and foremost that to bring about this ban, we have to reduce the power or prohibit the United States from exporting these weapons abroad, for maintaining a profit and using the arms industry as adjunct of the State Department and the military to spread violence and murder abroad.